I'm Katie from MB Tennis. Hope you guys are doing great today. Today we are going to be making a tier list. So what is a tier list? A tier list is essentially ranking something from greatest to least. So in today's case, we will be ranking male tennis players, more specifically male tennis player Grand Slam champs since the Open era has begun. So I'm excited to really share my opinion on where I think people belong. And obviously it's my opinion, but also you're not going to have somebody maybe like Novak at C tier. But yeah, I'm just really excited to share where I think people belong in this tier list. I'm definitely going to be sharing my opinion. So for sure, there's going to be some people to disagree in the comments, but make sure you share your comments. Do you think certain people belong elsewhere? So also, don't forget to like and subscribe. This video, I hope, is going to get some traction because this is something that is kind of unique and not many people have done stuff like this. So I'm really excited to do this and share what I have. So let's start out with the one and only long retired John Newcomb. John Newcomb, I got my notes here, everybody. So like, this is a big deal. I got some notes here today. John Newcomb won 3 of the 4 Grand Slams, 7 singles Grand Slams total, 17 doubles Grand Slams. That's a lot of double slams, and was number 1 in the world for both singles and doubles. So right off the bat, that's pretty good. We're going to go with S tier. So one more thing I forgot to mention. S tier is like very good, obviously, but like God tier is clearly the best. C is not the best, but there's definitely going to be players that are in C tier that are world-class players. So Ken Rosewell deserves S tier. Okay. Very, very good on the accomplishment sides there. Next we have, do we want to work from the top up or the bottom? I'm thinking, you know what, let's do from the bottom up actually. So I did from the top, but let's do bottom. So next we have Jimmy Connors. Wow. That guy had a crazy career. Many Grand Slams won in singles. I'm not sure if he actually won double slams, but he's just so iconic that I believe that he belongs into S tier. So Jimmy Connors in S tier. Next, we have Gustavo Kuerten. Legend, legend, legend. I love this guy. He was huge for tennis in the 90s and 2000s. Really brought polyester string into the tennis world. Won French Open out of nowhere. I think he has 3 French Opens. Was number 1 in the world. So I believe that is A tier. And A tier because the people on S tier have won more slams. Even though I might like Gustavo more, I just can't put him any higher, I don't think. But this is where some people might disagree. So this is interesting. Next we have Marat Safin. Marat Safin, where are you on my notes? Yes. Okay, so Marat Safin, I think, won 2 slams. May have been number 1 in the world. This is where you guys are going to have to fact check me. I forget if he was number 1 in the world or not. But I think Marat Safin is probably B tier. B tier. Just because I feel like he could have been better, maybe. Seemed like he was pretty talented, had a really big serve, I think. But I just don't think he had the same amount of an impact on tennis as Gustavo Kuerten did. So that's why he's in B tier. So next, we have Bjorn Borg. Now, folks, this is where things are about to get dicey because if people that are maybe on the older or older watching this video, you guys obviously want him like high S tier or God tier. But I'm here to inform you that I'm just going to put him in S tier. Bjorn Borg is not God tier in my opinion. Just because of his accomplishments are not God tier, just like compared to some of the other people we have on the list. I think he had like 7 or 8 slams, which is clearly amazing. I wrote something down on him, but I'm trying to find it. Yeah, no, he's definitely S tier. I just don't think he is worthy of the God tier status. Don't get me wrong. I love him. I love that he's on the Laver Cup captains and all that stuff too. That's amazing. So yeah, S tier is a safe place for Bjorn Borg. Next, we have John McEnroe. If Bjorn Borg is an S tier, so is John McEnroe, because they were rivals. Love John McEnroe, great commentator. Also Laver Cup captain for Team World. They just won, so congrats to him. I think he won 9 slams, so he did win more than Bjorn, I think, did. He didn't win all the slams, but John McEnroe also was number one in the world, won some double slams, so definitely worthy of S tier. Arthur Ashe is going into A tier. He had 3 slams, 1 double slam, was number one in the world. He's in that realm of A tier. Gustavo, like I said, had 3 slams. Arthur Ashe had a major impact on tennis. We all know that. He's even got a huge stadium, the biggest tennis stadium in the world, named after him. That speaks for itself. So Arthur is in A tier. Dominic Thiem. All right, we're arriving in recent times here. Dominic Thiem is going to C tier. Sorry, Domi fans, but Dominic Thiem is just not going to get any higher than C tier. He has won 1 Grand Slam and 1 Slam only. No Olympic medals, no double slams, not number one in the world. He got to the finals, I think, in Roland Garros twice. But other than that, compared to these people here, just hasn't had the career that they've had. So he's going to be in C tier. I love Dominic Thiem, but just he's on C tier right now. Carlos Moya. Carlos Moya, where do I want to put you? I think Carlos Moya belongs. I'm going to say B tier. Only because I think right now he's superior to Dominic Thiem. So in that sense, if this list is done, if everybody's career stopped today, just so everybody knows that. So Carlos Moya had a better career than Dominic Thiem. It's just facts. So he belongs in C tier, or sorry, B tier. Excuse me. So yeah, I mean, Carlos Moya won a slam, was number one in the world. Coach of Rafa Nadal. I mean, he has much more on his resume than just those 3 things too. So that's why he's B tier. Daniil Medvedev is also going to go B tier. Very similar resume actually to Carlos Moya. In fact, I might even put him a little bit ahead because he's younger. I mean, where they are on the certain column doesn't really mean anything, but I just thought I would move him up just for fun. But yeah, won the US Open, number one in the world. Yeah, young, still got lots of career left. Next we have Peter Korda. He's going into C tier. He only won 1 slam. I don't even think he was number one in the world. Yeah, just won 1 slam. I know Peter Korda because he's the son of Sebastian Korda. So that speaks for itself. For me personally, I wasn't born when he won any slams or anything. So yeah, he's going to C tier. Next, we have Thomas Johansson. He's also going to go into C tier just because he's also only won 1 slam. A lot of people that won just 1 Grand Slam are going to find themselves into C tier. Just because that's kind of where they're going to be hanging out. Goran Ivanišević, I can't say the last name right. I'm so sorry. It's just not happening. I think he only won 1 Grand Slam too. Looking at my notes, and I think that's what he did have. I can't find him right now, but like, I really want to put him in B tier because I feel like he was, I think he's worthy of B tier. Like the big, yeah, he's going into B tier. This is just an opinion based. He's going into B tier. I've made the decision. Just because I don't feel like he just seems like more of a legend. Like he doesn't belong in C tier. He's definitely B tier worthy. I don't really have a lot of explanation on that. He's just going there. B tier for Juan Carlos Ferrero. Definitely going to B tier. Number one in the world. Won the French Open. Might even win an Olympic medal. Correct me if I'm wrong. I don't know. But it's the coach of Carlos Alcaraz. I think coaching is a big deal too. Even though we're talking about achievements, but like Carlos and Juan Carlos, like they coach some big players. So that's kind of like influential in my head. Next we have Juan Martín del Potro. This is huge. I wish I could put him up here, but that's just not happening. He's going to go to B tier also. I think he did the best he could, that man. It's really sad that he retired. I love his game. I think if he didn't get injured as much as he was, he would have won like maybe 5-6 slams, which is too bad. He had those wrist and knee issues. Love him. Arguably one of the best forehands ever. So Juan Martin, 2009 U.S. Open champ, is going to hang out. Also Olympic silver medalist. Yeah, B tier. He can definitely stay in B tier. He's even pushing C tier, or sorry, A tier, but I think B tier is safe for him. Albert Costa, right here, he's going to go into C tier. He only won one Grand Slam, and I believe that was the French Open, so he's staying there. Marin Cilic is also, Marin Cilic is going to go at the top of C tier just because he won the U.S. Open. He's still playing well today. He was finals in Wimbledon and finals of Australian Open. So a little bit more well-rounded than like Dominic Thiem. So that's why he's going to get high C tier. But yeah, we're like halfway, not even halfway through. We're doing pretty good right now. I'm confident in my choices. So like, if you are not happy with where people are on this list, you got to leave comment. You got to let me know how you feel. Okay. Andy Roddick. This is a tough one. This is going to be an, I kind of want to make this an opinion-based choice. You know what I mean? I don't know if Andy Roddick was number one in the world. I don't think he was. He definitely won a slam. I know he won a slam. And he was in the finals, I think, a few times for Wimbledon and lost to Roger. He's going into B tier. I made the executive decision. He just seems like more of a legend than like Marin Cilic and those guys, you know, like Andy Roddick, like iconic serve, like he's going into B tier. That's just where he belongs. Carlos Alcaraz, very young in his career. People are going to be pissed that I put maybe him at B tier, but that's where he belongs right now. Because if his career ended right now, he's got one slam and he's been number one in the world. I think that's just where he belongs. I mean, if you're comparing him to the other guys, he's got the number one world ranking above them. So that's why. Next, we have Evgeny Kafelov. I think he's from Russia. Had quite the career, actually. Two slams and singles, two slams and doubles, number one in the world, and a gold medal. Wow. He'll go in A tier. I don't really know much about him. Never got to see him play, but that resume is pretty impressive. So I think that's A tier worthy. But you don't really see him on the scene anymore, which is kind of sad. Don't ever see him on shows or anything. So would like to see and hear from him. I think next we have Michael Stich. I could be butchering that name. He won one Grand Slam in singles, one Grand Slam in doubles, and the gold medal. Interesting. I think that is also potentially worthy of... I think that is worthy of A tier. Just because, like, if you compare him to, like, Medvedev doesn't have a gold medal. He doesn't have a double slam. But they both have a single slam. So clearly, if you're just looking at records and stuff, Michael is a little bit better than Danil in that department. So that's why I put him in A tier. Stan Smith, iconic man. Two slams and doubles, five slams. Sorry, two slams and singles, five slams and doubles, and number one in the world in both. That is A tier. And he's also got cool shoes. I don't have them, but like millions of people wear them. So that's cool. We have, I'm going to butcher this name too, Ilya Nastes. Very popular player, like I think in the 70s, 80s. He won two slams, singles, one, three Grand Slams and doubles, and was number one in the world. That's also worthy of A tier, in my opinion. Richard Krajicek from the Netherlands won one Grand Slam, and I think that was it. No number one in the world, no double slam, so that's C tier. I think this is Pat Cash. I always get Pat Cash and Pat Rafter mixed up. So I think this is Pat Cash. I think. Oh, my God. I am mistaken. That is actually Pat Rafter. Pat Rafter won two slams, one double slam, and was number one in the world. That's also worthy of A tier. Next, we have Thomas Muster. Thomas Muster, how many did he win? He won only one slam. That's worthy of C tier. Sorry, Thomas. Thomas Muster kind of looks like a badass, but he's going to go in C tier just because. That's just where he's going. Next, we have Leighton Hewitt. Very, very iconic, especially for Aussie tennis. He only won one slam, though. So I think he's going to go... I don't know. I think he belongs low-end B tier. Just because he's had a big impact on Australian tennis. I feel like putting him in C tier would be a disservice. You know what I mean? I don't know. We're going to leave him in B tier. Might get some flack for that one. Let's go with... Who do we have next? Oh, I forget his name. What is his name again? Gomez? Is his name? Last name? Something Gomez. Oh, man, guys. I am struggling with this guy's name. I forget his name. It's something Gomez. Anyway, he won one slam in singles and one slam in doubles. I'm going to put him in C tier. Sorry, he's just going to C tier. Michael Chang is also going to go into C tier just because he only ever won one slam. And although that one slam was very cool, I think he won like at a really young age. He was not number one in the world either. So, I think next we have Pat Cash, who only ever won one slam too. Yeah, Pat Cash only ever won one slam. So he's going to stay there. Next, we have Sergey Bulgera, who won two singles Grand Slams. We'll put him in B tier. I think that's safe. Next, we have Vytas Gerulaitis. Gerulaitis, he's from the U.S., or at least was a citizen of the U.S. He won one slam in singles, one slam in doubles. Decisions. I think... he's definitely a B or a C. I just don't know if he's a... I don't know. A lot of the old... you know who talks about him? John McEnroe talks about him a lot. So if somebody's talking about him a lot, like a legend like John McEnroe, he's going to B tier. John McEnroe influenced my decision there. Stefan Edberg is definitely going into A tier. Stefan Edberg, let me pull up his resume. Stefan Edberg won six slams, single slams, six single slams. Was number one in the world for singles and doubles, and won three doubles grand slams. So that's definitely S tier, like no questions needed. Stan Wawrinka is going to be A tier. He won three grand slams, is still playing. In his prime, that guy was like, you did not want to play him. He was dangerous. So yeah, hopefully you guys agree with that one because I think he's definitely worthy. We have arrived at a very big name, Pete Sampras. 14 singles grand slams. This is where I might really start getting some, you know, comments that are disagreeing with me. He's not going to go in A tier. He's not going to go in S tier, but he's going to go into C tier. No, I'm just joking. He's going into God tier. Pete Sampras, I was going to say greatest serve of all time, but one of the greatest serves of all time. Probably the greatest servalier of all time, maybe, arguably. But I think he is worthy of God tier. He was considered the greatest of all time for a long, long time. Until Roger kind of took that away from him. But I think if you are kind of considered the greatest of all time at one point, you know, you deserve the God tier, you know, column. Next, we have Roy Emerson. I think this is Roy Emerson. Roy Emerson won 12 Grand Slams, was number one in the world, and won 16 double slams. Wow. That's a tough one. This is definitely an S tier or a God tier player. I don't think I'm going to put him in God tier, though, because the reason for that is some of these slams were won before the Open era had begun. So I'm sorry. I just don't think, if this is Open era only, so like if you had won slams prior to and you played in both, I don't think, I can't count that. I think he's just S tier, just S tier. Don't get me wrong. Still amazing, but like might get some flack for this one too. People might say like, how can you put Sampras in God tier, but not Roy Emerson? I don't know. This is just my opinion too. I think he goes in S tier. Rod Laver, however, it goes in God tier. Okay. Doesn't really matter the order there. Why Rod Laver has won all the singles grand slams in a row twice. That has never happened ever, ever before on men's or women's side of tennis. That is incredible. Okay. He's huge for the Laver Cup. Also, he's like, I mean, his name's in it. He won six grand slams and doubles, and I think was number one in the world in both. So that's God tier. No questions asked. Rafa Nadal is going to go into God tier. He is currently the all-time leader for singles grand slams at 22 grand slams. Was number one in the world for many, many years. Most grand slams at Roland Garros of all time, and has a gold medal. I mean, the list goes on and on. I could talk about Rafa all day, but no, like, he needs to go to God tier. If people have a problem with that, then, like, you, I don't know what's wrong with you. There's a couple players that are still left, and the folks that are already there definitely deserve it. So I will definitely debate for who I'm putting in God tier. S tier for Andre Agassi. 8 Grand Slam singles. Andre Agassi had a rough go. He had a rough upbringing. I read his book. Highly suggest everybody reading that book. Actually, it's a great read. But yeah, Andre, great career. 8 Grand Slams, number one in the world. He's S tier worthy. Mats Wilander from Sweden is going to go. I just want to find my notes on him real quick, make sure I'm not making any mistakes. I think he won 7 slams, number one in the world. I don't know where I put my notes on him. Mats Wilander won 7 grand slams, number one in the world in singles, and also won a double slam. That's definitely worthy of S tier. All right. Next we have... Ken Rosewall. Ken Rosewall won 8 Grand Slam singles and was number one in the world for singles also. That is also S tier. I think some of those were before the Open era though, so I could put him here, but I'm not going to do that. He's S tier. Rod Laver, I know, talks about him quite a bit. He was pretty influential. I think he's from Australia too. So yeah, he goes in S tier. Jim Courier, folks, we're getting now to the nitty gritty near the end of the list. Jim Courier, I think, had 3 slams, maybe. Jim Courier, where are you? Jim Courier. Jim Courier had 4 slams, excuse me, 4 grand slams in singles and was number one in the world. That's A tier. Definitely worthy of A tier. Yvonne Lendl won 8 grand slams in singles and was number one in the world. That is also S tier. Oh, nope. Get him out of there. He's not God tier. He is S tier. I mean, if you look at all the S tier, I think that's pretty even, in my opinion. And honestly, the whole list right now, in my opinion, is pretty good. There's a couple players that maybe could go in one or another. But yeah. Okay, folks. The time has come. You know who this guy is. This guy right here. Roger Federer. Roger is going into God tier. I'm sorry. Sometimes it just puts him in front of the other person. The way the God tier is laid out does not mean like who's God of God tiers. But maybe I'll save that for the end. I'll do a little something there. Roger is definitely worthy of God tier. 20 slams, most consecutive weeks at number one in the world. Won all the Grand Slams. I think he's got a gold medal and a silver medal. I might be wrong on that. I think I might be, but like, yeah. Let's just talk about Roger for a second. The guy is so amazing. The most beautiful tennis player ever to play tennis. Ever. I think we all cried the other day when he retired. It was just what it is. Rafa cried too with him, so it's okay if you cried. So yeah, sad times that he's retired now, but he is definitely worthy of God tier. On to the next one, Novak Djokovic. Wow, we're not messing around here. Novak is also God tier. That guy's just like a spider monkey out there. Huge respect for his game. I think he gets a bad rap because of all the stuff. He has the most weeks at number one, but not consecutive. He's won all the slams. I think he won a bronze medal. Yeah, definitely worthy of God tier though. Wow, he's 21 slams. He's right behind Rafa, one ahead of Roger. So those guys, all three of those are God tiers. We got Boris Becker. Boris Becker is going to go 6 slams. He won number one in the world and a gold medal. He goes in S tier. Just because if you look at people in that S tier, he's definitely worthy. Very iconic serve. It's too bad what's happened to him now, though, like him being in jail and stuff. Maybe make a video about that. But yeah, don't want to go too far into that stuff. But yeah, definitely worthy of S tier, his performance and his career. And last but not least, Sir Andy Murray. Now, this one is going to be very controversial where I put him. And I'm actually going to put him in S tier. Because he played 5 Grand Slam finals before he actually won a slam. 4 or 5. So that's huge. And they were all against Roger, Rafa, and Novak, I believe. So without Roger, Novak, and Rafa, like Andy Murray would be like filthy rich on Grand Slams, I think. He was number one in the world, won a gold medal. Won Davis Cup too, I think. Like, the guy has a very good tennis resume. So, people will disagree with this because, like, for example, Querten, Wawrinka, they all have 3 Grand Slams. But I think his game, his performances, the records he has, he's by far the greatest player to ever come out of Great Britain. He's S tier, man. So that is what I have right now. I'm going to make a few modifications such as this. I'm going to move him here, and I'm going to move him here, and I'm going to move him here. Roger, Rafa, and Novak all go at the top of God tier because I believe they're all equal in their own ways. Until one of them blows by the other one and Grand Slams, and by blowing by, I think is at least 3 to 4 slams. So if Rafa gets to 24 or Novak gets to 24 or 25, then I think the list could look like this. But in the meantime, they're all even. So just because Rafa's at the top doesn't mean he's the best of the best. However, I believe he's the arguably the best because he has the most slams. But I want Roger to be the best. But there's a lot of debating that happens there. But Pete Sampras and Rod Laver, they're at the back end of God tier because they just don't have the achievements, in my opinion, compared to those guys. But that is going to be it, folks. Let me know what you think of this list and tell me all the disagreements you have too, because I want to hear those. And let me know if I forgot about anybody. Guaranteed, I forgot about a few players. This video took a lot of time to make, so please like and subscribe. It's definitely something different. And if you want me to make a women's one, I'm happy to do that as well. But yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll catch you guys in the next video. This is my tier list.